The Social Economic Rights and Accountability Project, SERAP, and other pressure groups across the country has urged Abubakar Malami, the Attorney General of the Federation, to end what they say is the persecution of Omoyele Sowore. Can and will he adhere to the admonition? And also, the police and the Police Service Commission has been a tough war over the recruitment of 10,000 constables over whose right it is to conduct the exercise. Is the feud caused by the recently passed police reform bill? This is Plus Politics, and I am Felicity Ezewike. The Social Economic Rights and Accountability Project, SERAP, has sent an open letter to Abubakar Malami, the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, urging him to use his position to halt what they say is the prosecution of Omoyele Sowore and Olawale Bakare. The duo has been charged with charges of terrorism, fraud, and insulting President Muhammadu Buhari. With me to discuss this is two gentlemen. Noble Obasi is a legal practitioner. Thank you very much for coming to the program.
My pleasure to be here.
And of course, we have a regular here, Alester Wilkos, political analyst. Pleasure to have you join us once again.
It's always my pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Let me come to you. A lot of persons have called for the release of Omoyele. They say that he's not been prosecuted, he's been persecuted. Is the government guilty as charged?
Thank you, Fidelity. Well, on the issue of Omoyele Sowore, the law is very clear on how you arrest and detain citizens of this country. Because according to this, the Constitution, which is the ground norm, which is what we operate on, it says that when there is an arrest of a citizen of this country and subsequent detention, such person should be charged to the court within 24 hours. Within 24 hours, that's if the court is within 48 kilometers radius. However, if the court is not within 48 kilometers radius of where the person was arrested and detained, then after two days, the person should be charged to court. So for Omoyele Sowore to still be in the custody and being charged perhaps after 45 days?
Yes.
That's on last week Friday.
Is this continued detention in this instance? Because 45 days is what the court gave to them. Can they or do they have the legal rights to hold him for more than those days?
I don't think so. They don't have any legal rights.
Okay. Let me come to you, Mr. Wilkos. Well, your reaction to the new treasonable charges, fraud, insulting the president, and this was filed on Friday. What is your reaction?
I am very much sympathetic to Mr. Sowore. We shouldn't have gone to this point that Mr. Sowore has led himself and led a lot of Nigerians to. If at the time that Mr. Sowore was going on his wild goose chase, SERAP and other notable personalities have called him to order and have told him, gentlemen, you need not go this route. If they had done that, where elders have spoken to him, his family members, and people of note, let me take SERAP today that is calling for his release, or those who are saying Mr. Sowore has been persecuted rather than persecuted, if they had, at the time Sowore was going for in his wild good chase, had called him to order and said, you don't fight the state in this manner, maybe he wouldn't have come to this level. As for his arrest, there must be law and order in a society. Nobody wakes up and starts threatening the entire country. It's not done anywhere. Even where we copied our democracy, it's not done anywhere.
But does it justify his actions? They said he's trying to topple the government. But looking at the scenario that we have right now, has he actually showed true cause? They say if you go to court, the onus is to prove the case.
Yes.
Is he really calling for a revolution to topple the government?
That is what the prosecution will present before the court. And his lawyers will puncture at the court.
But in your opinion,
in my opinion, I've not seen the charge. I've not seen the investigation file. I don't have preview to all that had transpired. All I can say from this point is the actions that we have seen, either on the page of newspaper, on social media, on speeches that has been made, and all what that's what I can base. Now, the nitty-gritty, because he's been charged for treasonable felony, he's been charged for money laundering, he's been charged for insulting the president. For me, I think that's a ridiculous one. I don't, because this president has stomached all insults. His obituary, they made the caricature of his obituary.
Well, doesn't that bring to mind the fact that maybe there, those people that are saying these are trumped up charges may have a point?
Why don't they have? Why don't they go to the court? You see, simple things. And I think in this country, we should stop overheating the politics or overheating the country because they want to become relevant. At this point, Mr. Sowore is under arrest, lawful arrest. Now, my brother talked about 48 hours being held. Now, after 48 hours, what did the DSS do? They approached the court and asked for 90 days. Let's get something clear. He was arrested based on information of treasonable felony. Okay? That's why he was arrested. Sowore has gone around the whole country canvassing for votes. Sowore has held press conferences. Sowore has even disrupted, he didn't start his activism today. He has disrupted programs that were going on in New York and other places held by the federal government and officials. He has gone around the country talking about Nigeria, how to make Nigeria better, pointed an election. Nobody has arrested Sowore. So Sowore now woke up one day and said he's doing revolution now. Now, no, there must be no law enforcement agency, no security apparatus anywhere in the world will fold their arms and said somebody wants to do revolution. The first thing about revolution is what? Violence takeover. That is revolution. That is the simple definition.
Okay,
or let me. Heavy attack on, and if I say revolution, want to declare revolution on a particular subject, it means heavy attack on that subject.
Okay, let me interrupt you and get a bit of clarity on the aspect of this Cyber Crime Act. I think that's what it is called, Cyber Crime Act in Nigeria. Serap, in your statement, alluded to the fact that a high-ranking member of the Ministry of Justice or thereabouts said they were going to review an aspect of the Cyber Crime Act that deals with insulting public officials. And Serap, they are saying that it is being used in this case and has been done previously to undermine freedom of expression. What is your take on this? If you can just clarify that aspect that they are talking about and your general take on this.
Okay, so for the Cyber Crime Act, I want to believe that it's an act meant for, say, perpetrators of internet fraud. And in the case of freedom of speech, so I believe it's a ground norm in the Constitution under the fundamental human rights that each citizen in Nigeria has the right to freedom of speech. However, once you abuse your freedom of speech, for example, when you go into defamation and perhaps libel, then obviously your right is violated. So for the Cyber Crime Act to want to infringe into freedom of speech, I feel it's unnecessary. I feel freedom of speech on its own is something which we as human beings, we are bound to have. And for us, we need to express it freely without no interference or without no fear from any authority whatsoever, in as much as we do it in the right way and in as much as we say the right things and at the right time.
Okay, there are so many issues to look at here, but I want to take still on that Serap statement, because that's particularly what we're emphasizing on. An aspect of it says laws against terrorism and money laundering should be properly used and not to undermine critical voices, activists and the media. The statement also said invoking the charges of treasonable felony to unjustifiably or arbitrarily restrict the right of freedom of opinion would minimize the seriousness of which our laws traditionally treat such offenses and undermine the essence of the criminal justice system as well as the rule of law. Do you agree with this position?
Honestly, I would not totally agree with that. Okay, because so treasonable felonies, these are offenses which warrants perhaps death penalty. Because it's an offense which touches on the state of the nation. And I believe if anyone is found guilty for that, the person should go in for that. But however, since it's a very heavy offense to prove, so once you allege that someone has committed a treasonable felony, you have to go through you have to make sure it is well established so that you don't punish the innocent person. Okay, so for what Serap is saying, I would not totally agree with that. I would believe that being a law, anybody that infringes the law should go in for it. However, if for the authority to establish that people infringe the law, then they have to go all extent, because in the law courts, it's always beyond every reasonable doubt. So you have to prove beyond every reasonable doubt that is the offense. But if there is an iota of doubt, I don't think the offense will fly.
I'll come back to you to talk about what a senior advocate of Nigeria said. But let me bring you in and ask you about this request by Serap to Malami to, drop the charges against Sowore. They are saying it is persecution, not a prosecution. Do you think at this stage that the AGF can do anything, considering the fact that the case is up in court on Tuesday?
The AGF tomorrow, at any point in time, can enter nolle prosequo on any matter that in his opinion he considered cannot be sustained based on evidence available, or in any manner he just so feels. He can wake up from the rest of his bed, maybe he had a dream and he himself and Sowore were sharing a glass of wine in the dream, and he just woke up and entered nolle prosequo. That's what the law allows the AGF to do. But such right, of course, such privilege must be expressed, must be exercised within context of national security and nationalism.
But can he drop it as being requested
as it is
now, considering that it's
as it is now? I don't think the AGF has any reason to. Okay, he can enter it at any point in time. Even when addresses has been taken, I wait so long as even on the day of judgment, he can say enter nolle prosequo and then end the matter. The issue now is this: I think Serap is jumping the gun, and we cannot have a good society if civil societies do not partner with government on issues of national security. You see, that you're a civil society doesn't make you automatic critic of government, or every action of government is under your scrutiny and criticized. You don't say anything good about government, okay? That's where I started my opinion from. Where in a civil society, Serap is a respected civil society, and they have done quite a substance. But if you see yourself as always opposed to government actions, then I think you have other things other than being a formidable civil society group. And I said it clearly. When Sowore was contesting
the
election...
Has Serap actually presented themselves, in your opinion, over the years with their agitation for public rights and, good governance and all of that? Have they presented themselves in any way to be considered not credible enough to speak on this particular issue?
They have a right to speak. I'm not denying their rights. But again, their right now is raised to our public scrutiny and critic. Serap has intervened in so many issues, which is their legitimate right to do. But me, I'm saying, is it everything that government does that you find fault? Are there no things that government... I've never seen Serap come to praise the government. I've never.
But maybe in this particular instance, let's not get distracted. Yes. In this particular instance now, the case before the court, that will come before the court again tomorrow.
Yes.
You're saying that their priority is misplaced at this time?
At this time, totally misplaced. And I'm happy that the lawyer is saying that he doesn't agree with Serap, because I didn't agree with them in any respect of ramification. Let me say this, and I said it clearly in my opening statement. When Sowore started this wild goose chase, because I've had a wild goose chase, Sowore does not possess, I don't know, but from the face value, Sowore does not possess any capacity to bring down a government. I know that from face value. However, I do not know the underground plans and the underground currents that were fueling his actions. Because at some time they said, when you see a bird dancing in the middle of the road, the drummer may be inside the bush.
Okay.
So just let me tie this in. Okay. So Sowore actions, utterances, statements, maybe intentions, for me, runs contrary to national security, and for which if Serap really have loved Sowore and loved this country, would have called Sowore to order well in our head. And say, the area you're going
point.
Is very, very non-sustainable.
All right, Noble, would you want to add a thought to that, or I should go straight to the question?
Okay, so initially, let me just put in a few words. So initially, I talked about the fact that I do not totally agree with the position of Serap.
Yeah, it was a particular phrase.
Yes, particular phrase. So to an extent, I believe the society is meant for people to check. Okay, so the citizens is supposed to checkmate
the
government policies.
The activities of the government.
Exactly. And if Serap as a body or perhaps as an organization is always out there to criticize the policies of the government, I think it's quite healthy. I'm not undermining the fact that there might be certain things which they would do or certain statements which they would do which might not totally fall into place with the intentions of this nation. But however, what they are doing to try to, canvass support for Sowore, to an extent, it's appreciable. But however, when they are doing those things, they need to do it within the ambit of the law.
Still talking law now, because that's your area of specialty. The senior advocate of Nigeria, Michael Ozekome, we know him, everybody knows him, you know him. He has come out in an interview to say that the new charges against Sowore is dead on arrival. Do you share similar opinion?
To be honest with you, I didn't watch the interview, but from my own perspective, I want to say
the charges basically, like we've highlighted here, has to do with money laundering, insulting the president, and some other issues. And he's saying that these new charges that's being brought against Sowore is dead on arrival, in his opinion, because he is a senior advocate of this country. It's fair enough to take his opinion into consideration. That's why I'm asking you that question.
I totally agree with some of the what his opinion on some of the charges, because, for example, when you say insulting the president, I mean, you cannot categorize it as an offense, because under the law, for any offense.
Just hold on to that thought, right? We will go on a very, very short break, and when we come back, we'll continue this conversation. Do stay with us.